Hej, Tesla Doel här. Idag var Luca och jag på Barnens flyghelg på Aeroseum i Säve. Aeroklubben i Säve fyller 100 år. Det kommer rätt mycket folk. Klockan 12.15 på programmet var det någonting som låter väldigt spännande. Ett elflygplan. Det kan vi inte missa.
Och det första man ska göra förstås när man kommer till Säve är att ställa in telefonen i flygplansläge.
Ska vi sälja Tesla och köpa en liten helikopter istället, Luca? Inte? Du vill inte, nej. Då sparar vi Tesla.
Slovenia. We are here proud to present our first serially produced electric training aeroplane. I don't know if you realize that, but today you are part of history, because for the first flight in the skies of Sweden, electric aviation is enabled. In fact, our factory demo pilot, Nate Spanalev, is just taking off. If you look towards the runway behind the helicopters, you will see a small, white, high-wing aeroplane. This is the Alpha Electro. This is the aeroplane that will be available here in Sweden next year for the training of next-generation pilots. It is a game-changer. 1 hour of flying on this aeroplane costs around 20 kronor. How amazing is that? But there are also other things that are amazing about this plane. Nate is turning around and he's approaching us from your right. And you will see the plane, but you will barely hear it. Do you see how quiet it is? This is how aviation will sound next year. It is happening today. It's not 20 years. In the future, it's not 30 years in the future. Electric aeroplanes are real and they are usable.
The enda ljud som man hör är från propeller. The only sound is from the propeller.
Yes, it is the propeller that is pushing the air backwards, otherwise allowing the aeroplane to fly. Alpha Electro uses a 100 horsepower engine equivalent. So it is a powerful aeroplane, it is a capable aeroplane. Right now, the aeroplane is not using even half the power because it is so aerodynamic. It is powered by lithium batteries, similar to the batteries you have in your mobile phones, in your laptop. But this is technology adapted for aviation. There is many safety features on the aeroplane. In fact, the aeroplane is a flying digital network. It has electronics built in that listen to what every component of the aeroplane is doing. And because of that, the flying for the pilot is more pleasurable. Because he does not need to look at what the plane is doing. The plane tells him how it is feeling. Nate is coming from your right-hand side for a low approach, even closer. Even for the past week here in Sweden, I heard that the aeroplane flew more than 6 hours and our airports to allow operations in the future. These chargers can charge the plane in 45 minutes. And in the future, this time will go down towards 15 minutes only. So it is basically close to the time it needs to refuel an aeroplane. No more waiting. So Nate is climbing up with a light hand turn to get some energy, get some speed, and get you excited.
Ställa frågan till honom om den har samma funktion som elbilar har, att den laddar på vägen ner. Is it loading on its way down?
Yeah. So electric engines and batteries have the possibility of actually working as a windmill when the airplane is descending. So you are not only saving fuel, you are actually putting it back into the batteries every time the airplane descends. Nate is doing a high-speed flight around 250 km per hour. This airplane is also a hybrid one. It's not only a trainer, and every instructor will love that because their engine is responsive, there is a lot of power available, and the airplane is so much fun to fly. So even with these maneuverings, the airplane is a little bit quieter than before, but it's not even close to what gasoline power engines would do. You have to remember that the airplane is now close to acrobatic flight. Nate is pushing 4G maneuvers. This means that his body weight now is under 4 times more kilograms than what you would feel here underground. The airplane is flying high speed. Before you saw it, that speed a little bit of drain, around 150 kilometers per hour. Now the airplane is flying about 200 kilometers per hour. And all of that without recharging in between. In fact, the airplane can fly for more than 1 hour doing what you are seeing it do. So it is not something that would need recharging all of the time. It is important that pilots, which will become pilots of large airplanes, also learn about the maneuvers and how to correct mistakes in these maneuvers. And this is also what Pipistrel with the Alpha Electro is bringing, not only to the skies of Sweden, but to skies worldwide.
Det är helt otroligt att ett elektriskt flygplan kan göra de här sakerna. Och om jag fattar det rätt så var det 20 kronor i timmen som det kostar att flyga den här. Jämfört med bränsle och allt annat. Så är det.
Moment, the Pipistrel Alpha Electro is the only aeroplane which is shipping to customer and electric power. There is many things going on the prototype level. So electric flight is taking off like it has not taken off before. In the last 2 years, more than 50 companies are trying to come up with concepts on how electric flight will look in the future. Some of them are trying to compete with us. Others are trying to develop electric flying cars. The design space is incredible. But here it is an aeroplane that is real today, and will only get better. Now, for a surprise. 3, 2, 1, Nate's coming from the back. Is it quiet or is it quiet?
Vi som är här, vi har varit med om något historiskt. Det här kan ni vara stolta över. Tack så hemskt mycket.
Här så att ni kan gå och titta på den sen. Pappa. Jag har ett jättegrädd kandidater att berätta. Tärneken kommer att bygga Sveriges största solcellspark på fältet och norrut. De räknar inte för här. Samman med detta så kommer de att hjälpa Aeroklubben. Så vi kan bli den första klubben i Sverige. Första klubben i världen som använder ett elflygplan som laddar ifrån lokal grön. Det är fantastiskt roligt. Och jag hoppas att det är här. Men jag tror att det är flygplan. Det är särskilt en stor applåd.
Thank you again for the warm reception. We are proud to be here, we are excited to be here, and we will be even more excited when the first delivery of the electric plane is made to Sweden. So help us grow the community, help us spread the word how great of it electric aviation is, and there will be many more Alpha Electros here to stay.
Utan också Måns, ni har ett 100-årsjubileum här på Aeroklubben i Göteborg. Och det ska vi veta allihopa, för 100 år sedan så var det en del utav god Göteborgsanda, några gentlemän satt och planerade för framtiden, och därmed var Torslanda grundat. Svenska Aeroklubben, den är vår absolut äldsta medlem. Näst äldst i Europa, äldst i norra Europa.
Gratulerar!
Stort tack! Det här är helt fantastiskt att vara med och ta en klubb 100 år gammal in i framtiden. Det är fantastiskt!
Grattis! Och jag önskar er lycka till i 100 år till.
Airbag for the car, also a tripwire, if you crash it disconnects all the high voltage, but in normal operation it powers the avionics. But the big battery charges the small battery, and then the small battery powers the avionics. And also if you have a failure in the high voltage system, like an engine failure, you still need a radio maybe to call somebody. So.
And how powerful is the battery on it?
So it's 22 kilowatt-hours. If you meant the capacity now. Yeah. In terms of power delivery, this is a 100 horsepower system equivalent.
I could fly an hour.
An hour and 20 minutes.
I know, 20 minutes totally.
Yeah, totally. So here in aviation, you have to have a certain reserve, 20 minutes, and 1 hour is what we call useful flight.
And how is glide flying capability?
It's about 15 to 1. Much better than typical aeroplanes.
Yeah.
This is also why the plane is so efficient in terms of power usage. You have to have an efficient aeroplane to put an electric system on it, otherwise it's just too power hungry. It's about a 15 to 1 aeroplane.
Great.
It's a Cessna has a 7 to 1. Diamond is a 11 to 1.
Wonderful.
Of course, in the battery here, we have to take care of safety, but we have nothing flying into the battery. Like a Tesla is on the floor, and if you drive over some object, like a big rock or something, they also have to make sure
that there is no punctures.
Yes, okay. I have 3 millimeters. Yeah.
So for us, the biggest thing we can hit is a bird.
Yeah.
And the battery is protected from where the bird would hit. Yeah? It's like behind the propeller. So we essentially don't engineer the battery to take impacts from the outside.
Yeah,
but Tesla has to.
Yeah.
So if you take a look at the Tesla battery, the weight of what we call active components is not 600 kilos, but the whole damn box, which has to protect it from this kind of foreign objects, then makes up the weight.
The battery is located in the front.
And in the and in
behind
the back. One in the front, one in the back.
All right, you have two. I heard also you could deliver only the drive-line, the motor.
Yes,
and
we
the
also do that.
Yeah. And it's a converter.
Yes,
it's a frequency converter to
it's an inverter, DC to AC.
Inverter. Yeah.
Motor is three phase, and essentially battery is directional.
It's a three phase.
Yes.
And there's no gearbox. It's direct.
It's direct
to the to the motor. Yeah.
The motor is actually smaller than the spinner, so the design of the engine is 75. In this plane, we fly it at 60 because it's enough. It's a light plane; you don't need so much power. We also have a 40.
You have 40.
Yeah, we have a 50 horsepower.
And you can deliver that, and the whole drivelines.
Yeah.
Oh, just what
we call it the plug and play system.
Yeah, exactly, plug and play.
My background is electrical engineering.
All right.
I'm leading the design department, but then we have a chief engineer who actually does the certification signing.
How many employees are you?
62.
62.
62 in the, that's the name of the street, yeah.
Yeah?
Where is town?
Town is Ajdovščina.
Where in Slovakia? Yeah,
in Slovenia. It's near Trieste.
Slovenia.
Yeah. We are 1 hour east of Venice. So the bigger town in the vicinity is Trieste. It's a small place, it's 5,000 people, you don't know it.
Do you have a fob as well?
No. There's no fob. There's no keys. It's
no fob, no keys.
But there is the key to the door, but once you are in.
Okay.
Thank you very much for doing this.